Hi friends, this is NJ, host on this channel. So we will continue our discussion on the nakshatra number 6, which is the Ardhara nakshatra. In this part, we will try to understand the personality traits and the identifying traits as it has been ascribed by our ancient sages, because they look at these nakshatras as the bodies, the astral bodies with real life in them. So before we'll start our discussion, just a quick recap of all what we have studied so far. We have discussed that this Ardhara nakshatra falls in the zodiac sign of Gemini from 6 degree 40 minutes to the 20 degree. The deity, the gods associated with this nakshatra is the god Rudra, the fierce form of Lord Shiva. When it comes to the symbol associated with this nakshatra, so a teardrop, diamond and a man's head is being associated with this nakshatra. Like the way I always say, just a complete contemplation of the deity and the symbol is going to give you a lot of idea about the functioning of this nakshatra. The association of Lord Rudra makes it, you know, in sync with all kind of transformation, all kind of upheavals, all kind of destruction, because symbol which has been associated with it is a teardrop. So which also tells about the process of catharsis. You know, when you all the, because tears just act as a medium of emotional release for all the pent up nervous energies. Same ways, the storms, the thunderstorm, the lightning, the rains, which has been associated with this nakshatra, also tells about the replenishment, the rejuvenation of the nature. So this is all what we get to know from the one symbol. A man's head just tell about the intelligence, and I've already explained at the introductory video, just because of the association of the planet Mercury and the Rahu, that makes this nakshatra very highly intellectual. Same is the case with the diamond, which has been associated as another symbol to this nakshatra. And you all know that diamond is the hardest substance known, which also makes these people under the influence of Ardhara nakshatra very unrelenting and gives them a very strong determination. So all of that we have discussed in the previous video. Like the way each nakshatra has its own power, this nakshatra has the yatna shakti, power to gain after lots of efforts. Along with that, this nakshatra is also known as the star of sorrow. So now we will try to understand the functioning of this nakshatra as well, which we have discussed in the previous video. So this nakshatra just makes someone, you know, give a very childlike nature, you know, in the form of one moment you are completely overwhelmed by the sorrow, and immediate next moment you are completely joyful. So this is all what the energy of the Rahu is, which is working on this nakshatra, which gives, whether in the form of misfortune or whether in the form of some good thing, it is going to happen in a sudden form only, like a sudden strike of, you know, a thunderstorm. So all of that can be seen as the functioning of this nakshatra. These people goes through lots of upheavals, lots of ups and downs in the life. They remain to be highly intellectual. They also remain very helpful and concerned towards the pain of others. The negative side of their personality is that violent temperament, very destructive impulse, you know, very negligent attitude towards the finances, you know, not giving proper thought before speaking. So all of those remains to be a part of their inherent personality. But one thing which is very sure is that these people tend to remain the most intellectual ones. It will all depend on how much is the the evolutionary level of the soul is, or how the other planets in the chart is placed, because this intelligence can be used if it is not being affected by the negative side of Rahu, which is about the confusion, which is about the illusion. Then person might get into, you know, all kind of treachery, all kind of deception. But let's say, for example, if Rahu is acting in a proficient way, in a very sorted way, the person might use this intelligence in all the knowledgeable pursuit as well, in order to help others. When it comes to the defining traits of this nakshatra, so the caste allotted to this nakshatra is the Bhuchar caste. And as you guys know, this nakshatra is all about the destruction. Now, when I say repeatedly destruction, this could be looked at from that perspective that, you know, getting rid of all the old and worn out things, getting rid of your ego as well. This is what remains to be the embodiment and the representation of Lord Shiva is, that it destroys your ego, it destroys the illusion. So Bhuchar, which is all about, you know, getting rid of all the outlived things. So the caste allotted to this nakshatra is of a Bhuchar caste. The gender associated with this nakshatra is a female gender. Now, this will come as a surprising element to you because the male entity has been associated as a deity. Why then the gender is female? See, apart from one side of this nakshatra, which is about the, you know, chaos, which is about the upheaval, there is also another side of it, which is of moist, which is of, you know, nourishment, which is of care. You know, the what has been believed is that whenever the sun enters the Ardra nakshatra, that is the only time when the goddess, you know, earth goes through its menstrual cycle known as the Ambubachi Mela, which happens in the middle of the June every year in the Guwahati in India. So it has been also looked at from that perspective that Ardra has also got another side of it, which is very moist, which is very nourishing, which is very caregiving as well, a concern and empathy towards the pain of others. So the gender associated to this nakshatra is of a female gender. When it comes to the direction, so this nakshatra rules the west direction. When it comes to the body parts, this nakshatra rules the eyes and the front and back part of your head. The humor, the Ayurvedic constitution, so it has been given the kapha, the watery constitution. When it comes to the guna, tatva and the gana, so just because of the association of the ferocious form of the Lord Shiva, the Lord Rudra, the tamasic guna has been given to this nakshatra. More than the Rudra, it is the association of shadow planet Rahu, north node of the moon, that it has been given the tamasic guna. Tatva, it belongs to the water element. When it comes to the gana, this nakshatra belongs to the manushya guna, manushya gana. When it comes to the auspicious and the inauspicious activities which an individual can think of opting, so auspicious activities could be the worship of all the ferocious gods like Lord Bhairava, Lord Rudra, Goddess Kali is considered as auspicious. You know, all kind of creative pursuit which comes in the purview of this nakshatra, which we are going to discuss very soon, can be considered as auspicious. Apart from that, any kind of, you know, demolishing any building, getting rid of all the old and worn out things, closing your, cleaning your closet. So all those things about the removal can be seen as auspicious at the predominance of Ardra Nakshatra. When it comes to the inauspicious activities, so first of all, you know, all the auspicious activities are not considered good, like, you know, marriage, travel, joining a new organization. So all those activities are not considered as auspicious at the predominance of the Ardra Nakshatra. When it comes to the disposition, lunar month and the day, so the disposition of this nakshatra is, it is a crude, it is a Ugra Nakshatra, which has lots of potential, lots of intensity. Now that can be used for good, that can be used for bad, all depending on the evolutionary level of this soul or the placement of rest of the planets in the chart. So the disposition of this nakshatra is fierce, it's Ugra. When it comes to the lunar month and the day, so the Ekadashi, the 11th day of both the waxing and waning phases of the moon in its every monthly cycle has been associated with this nakshatra. When it comes to the lunar month, the second part of the Maghshirsh month, which falls in the month of the December, is associated with the Ardra Nakshatra. So the, you know, even in the second half of that Maghshirsh mass month in the lunar calendar, the middle 9 days are considered to be associated with this Ardra Nakshatra. And as per the English solar calendar, that is going to fall in the month of December only. When it comes to the sexual type and the celestial lineage, so the sexual type associated with this nakshatra is of a female dog. When it comes to the Gotra, the clan, the lineage, the sage Pulahu, the connector of space, has been associated with this nakshatra. And as this nakshatra has the energy of the planet Rahu, which is all about the, you know, sky, about the illusion, about the smoke, about the sci-fi, all of those things, so it makes sense as well that sage Pulahu should amongst those seven sages should be associated with this nakshatra as the predominant Gotra. When it comes to the profession and the places, so the profession will be, first of all the electricals, electrical engineer, computer software, people engaged in the sci-fi, gaming, software development are associated with this nakshatra. Apart from that, you know, all those doctors who prescribe homeopathy and the allopathy medicine can be seen as associated with the Ardhra Nakshatra. Apart from that, people dealing in any kind of weapons, weaponries, armories are considered as associated with this nakshatra or under the purview of this nakshatra. Politician, all those people who manipulate can be seen as under the domain or the purview of this nakshatra. Even the chemotherapist, you know, all those people who work with the radiation, so can be seen as under the purview of this Ardhra Nakshatra. When it comes to the places governed by this nakshatra, so all those geographical region, you know, where you will find the tornadoes, all kind of, you know, thunderstorms, can be seen as the places governed by this nakshatra. Apart from that, all the professions which we have discussed here will be automatically come in the domain of this Ardhra Nakshatra only. Even the film studios, the creative studio, the radio station, all of that will come under the purview of this Ardhra Nakshatra. So this is all what I wanted to say on my take on this Ardhra Nakshatra. This is a very intense nakshatra, you know, and it has got a very duality inside it. You know, like the way Gemini is a dual sign, even the Lord Shiva associated with this nakshatra has got two sides of him. You know, there's one side of Lord Shiva which is very very innocent, which is very easy to please, and there's one side of Lord Shiva which is very fierce, which is very ferocious. Same is the kind of energy which you'll find predominant in this Ardhra Nakshatra. All what depends is how the person is going to use that energy, whether he is going to waste his life in the meaningless pursuit, or the person is going to devote himself towards the help, nourishment, and towards the accumulation of the knowledge. So this is all what I wanted to say as my take on the nakshatra number 6, the Ardhra Nakshatra. I hope you guys found my this video informational. For further more updates and notification on astrology, please subscribe my channel and like my Facebook page. Thanks. Shivoham Shivoham.